السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. فیو مو احادیث آن دا ورچو آف مسجد الاقصی. عبداللہ ابن حوالہ رضی اللہ عنہ رپورٹس دیٹ دا میسنجر آف اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم سیڈ، ایٹ سم پوائنٹ یو ول بی اسپلٹ ان ٹو اسٹینڈنگ آرمیز، ون ان الشام، ون ان یمن، اینڈ ون ان عراق. Abdullah ibn Hawala radiyallahu anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, choose for me, Messenger of Allah, in case I live to see that day. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, go to Ash-Sham, for it is the chosen land of Allah in all his earth. He attract the chosen ones amongst his servants by sending them there. If you do not wish to go there, then go to Yemen and drink from its water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me a guarantee concerning Ash-Sham and its people. Another hadith, Al-Bara radiyallahu anhu narrates, we prayed along with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam facing Baytul Maqdis, Jerusalem, for 16 or 17 months. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to turn his face towards the Kaaba in Mecca. One more hadith. Al-Bara radiyallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed facing Jerusalem for 16 or 17 months. He desired that the direction of praying be towards the sacred house Kaaba. He performed Asr with a group of people. Then one of the men who had prayed with him left and passed by some people in a masjid who were bowing, who were in ruku'. He remarked, I testify by Allah that I prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam facing Mecca. They immediately turned towards the house. Some men had died or had been martyred before the Qibla change towards the sacred house. We did not know what to say about them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah verse of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not let your belief go to waste. Allah is all gentle, most merciful to mankind.